more Path of Exile 2 gameplay. Sorceress this time. I think it'll be a good character for even entry-level PoE players, honestly. And it just looks really cool, like Sorceress minion builds and all that good stuff, and so many like lightning sparks flying around and fire going around. Like, it looks really cool. Looks really cool. Yeah, let's hop into this PoE 2 Act 1 Sorcerer gameplay. Sorceress gameplay, I should say. Not Sorcerer. Finally, somebody playing on goddamn keyboard and mouse. I know some of you guys were upset that I was trying to bash console controller players or whatever, but nah, dude, it's just, I've played console literally my whole life, just about up to 2020, I would say up to 2020, 2019. That's when I kind of exited from the console space. So ever since then, I've just been PC, 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 PC. And if you are just on console and you've never played PC, you probably wouldn't understand unless you give it a shot, because I'm telling you this right now, PC just changes your whole entire world, dude. It does. It really does. Enough of that. Let's hop into this gameplay, boys. See what Sorceress is looking like. First, starting off with the first boss, easy. Yeah, look at that damage. Immediately? Oh my god. Yeah, this boss is gonna be super easy. We're gonna get this boss done super fast. I'm really just worried about the iron count. Look at that damage though. Oh my god. Yeah, as you can see, it's just a lot of dodge rolling and spell casting. Very, very safe. A very safe option for hardcore, I feel like. Look at that flame wall. Oh wait, this is another boss? Wait, what? Okay, so this is another boss in Act 1. Looks like an ice damage boss. He's using mainly fire spells, which makes sense. Those ice shards look like they do a lot of damage. I have not seen anybody run through this boss yet, so. Nice. Easy. Wait, Head of the Winter Wolf? Is that a divination card or whatever? What was that? Okay, so yeah, I think he's going through all the Act 1 bosses right now. Which is kind of what we really want to see as hardcore players. Even if you're going to be playing standard, definitely still good to know what you're going to be going up against. If you don't want spoilers, then you probably shouldn't watch this, but. Ooh. Ooh. Okay, this one's going to be a little weird. Easy boss, nonetheless. There goes him easily. Very nice.
I suppose very nice. I am not above culling simple creatures that lies in wait.
Okay, here we go with the rust boss. Let's see how the sorceress performs against the rust boss. The Rust King. Yeah, look at that damage, man. Oh my god. That is so nice. I still won't be playing Sorceress for a while, though, honestly. Sorceress will probably be the last character I ever play. It's like he's stacking up that fireball with the flame wall to do even more damage, which is kind of nuts. That's a lot of damage. That damage combo is nuts. And when he gets stunned, you're automatically already doing damage, but look at that health bar just dropping, dude. It's so much safe damage. Like, you don't have to be anywhere near the boss or anywhere near anything. Just throw out that flame wall, the sun, and immediately go for fireballs, and it's over. If you're gonna be playing Sorceress, you're gonna have a great time with damage. Seems like. Especially damage to bosses. Oh, he dropped the unique. Wait, hold on. Let me see that. One more time. I love that sound of the warp quarter staff. Oh my god, and it's a staff, yo. Oh, I wish he would check to see what staff that was. But yeah, again, so I think the full game, going through all the acts, is gonna take 25 hours or something like that. That's a long time. Like, we're still in Act 1. And there's so much space in between these bosses, you know? It's actually really nice. You get acquainted to your skills and all that, you know? See what type of combos you want to go for. Yeah, look at that damage. She's dead. She's dead so fast. So fast. This boss isn't gonna be too much. Oh, that degen. What is that degen? What is that? I guess if you stand in the hollow ground stuff or whatever. Battle music though, dude. Oh my god, look at that. Oh, that's so scary. Watching that health bar just drop and you don't know what's happening. It's just like, oh no. Flash attacks, okay. Yeah, some of these bosses we have never seen yet. Dodge. Beautiful. This guy's actually not a bad sorceress. I know some of the dudes that we've been watching are kind of like, meh, some of you guys were saying that. I fully agree with you guys. Like, I'd just be wanting to yell at the screen, like, do this, do that. Oh, yeah, okay, so that's probably the last boss's husband or whatever, or king. Or lover. Crazy degens. Not too bad. It's just a combination of the last boss and this new dude who just goes for sword slashes. He's gonna be a little rough for melee, but I don't think it'll be too bad. I'm going for a couple attacks, just get them dodges off as much as possible. Thank God there's no like stamina bar for the dodges. Imagine if there was an actual stamina bar for them. You can't like spam the dodges. Don't get any ideas, GGG. Please, no stamina bars. That would just increase the level of. Oh, that was close. My toes curled up for a second. All right, who we got here? Still all act one. Still all act one. I think there's way more bosses in each act than there was in POE 1. Look at that damage with the sun, the flame ball, dude. That's gonna be so busted. Such a busted combo. Yeah, some of these guys are just gonna be so scary to fight as a melee monk. Honestly, because I'm going monk. I'm definitely going monk. Thank God the arena is big enough to actually move around in too. Gotta keep moving with this boss, cause those soul things that move around you and then go in for the slam attacks, I know that's gonna hurt. Nice, beautiful dodge. Play with the sorceress though. Such a safe class. Oh. Almost out of potions. He's got it. Nice. Alright, we've seen this guy. Surely, surely we can.
You shouldn't have come back here.
Oh, you can charge it? Look at that. Oh, so you charge it and it.
Boom.
Oh.
I shall have my revenge.
So you can like set up the damage, kind of. That's really nice. Virtuous is looking really strong early game. Nice. Kind of manipulate the boss to move into the sun so you can get more damage going on the boss as you spam the fireballs. Smart. Oh, okay. Oh, look at that healthy. Oh my god, the health on the boss is just degenerating. Whatever that ability is. Pretty strong. Ooh. Ooh. That could have ended bad. Man, that fire damage is so strong. Oh. This makes me want to play Sorceress so bad early game and then just get gear for my monk or something like that. I don't know. If I die with the monk, I'll probably end up playing Titan. Maybe. I don't know. Or Mercenary. I don't know. There's so many good classes to choose from. I think when the game fully drops though and we get all our characters, I'm definitely going to probably main Shadow. Because that's who I mained in POE1. I love the mind builds and all that good stuff. I wonder if we're still going to have mind builds like we did in POE1. Would definitely love to play mind builds in this one. Oh. Okay, so he has a jump slam. And he does like an extra attack when he does the jump slam. Yeah, like that. Okay, because I'm tight to, as soon as he jump slams down, I would go behind him. But if he's going to turn around like that, I'm probably going to need to play like on the sides of him.
I should have made him stop.
Beautiful kill. This boss is a little bit more tankier to that fire damage. Clearly, I mean, it's got a whole bunch of candles on him. And it has that fire symbol right there, so I'm guessing it definitely is kind of fire resist. Yeah, this is gonna be a way longer fight, way longer fight. Projectile slashes. Oh, okay. Gonna have to be careful about that. That's kind of scary because he moves so fast when he does that. So as soon as he starts charging that, I'm going to need to get behind him so that he has to turn all the way around to get that off. That's going to be the strat. like that. Yeah, kind of. Not really like that, but you want to immediately start moving close to him so you can get around him. Yeah, like that. Yep. Beautiful. I can't wait to see what this sorceress is gonna do in the iron count fight. Fire is definitely not a good idea for this boss, unless you want to be fighting it for a while. Basic moves, nothing too crazy to worry about except for that fire breath thing. Damage in there. He's dropping a little bit faster with that ice damage. Beautiful dodge. This point in the game, I don't know how I'm gonna do these videos when I actually play. Like I said, I probably will do just full hours length worth of gameplay, unless you guys just want to end up seeing the bosses. But I kind of want you guys to join in on the journey with me, basically, you know. So when we do get up to endgame, it's kind of like an emotional moment, you know, because it's like, oh, we had this long journey, this long behind journey, crazy journey. Now we're going to do it again on another character. Like, you know, we're going to have so much content for this game, boys, so much content. Nothing really too crazy about this boss fight. Looked crazy at first, but definitely when you've been fighting the boss for like 15 minutes, I'm sure it just calms down a little bit. You could just flow with the boss.
exiles there. I just peeped too. This thing doesn't seem like it gets stunned, actually. Even though the stun meter builds up. It doesn't seem like it actually gets stunned. I don't think I remember seeing it get stunned once. That was a long fight. Long fight.
No noose this time.
This is the final boss of Act 1. Scary.
No.
The iron count.
Run, little rabbit! No escape! For the first ones!
This has a lot of sword slashes, an ice projectile, and a charge, okay. And a long, long swipe, sword swipe. For his first phase, at least. Nice. Nice. Beautiful stun. Oh, good damage. Good damage. Okay, he turned into the werewolf. That movie is so badass. Movie is so badass.
I think not. You are too weak to do the job. I'll find someone.
Incinerate!
You manipulative whore! How dare you abandon me?
How dare you abandon me?
Health reset. Resistant to ice, but since he's fire damage based right now, he's gonna be doing fat damage. Oh, bro, look at that. Oh, this part is so scary, dude. This part is so scary because there's so many enemies in that small pocket. It's just and this was just Act 1, man. Act 1. Oh my god. Ooh. Yes, sir. Oh my god, look at that fat damage. Oh my god, that was a huge, huge burst of DPS right there. Yeah, so it's probably going to be smart to have multiple elements to work with so you're not subjected to just one. Spam potions at that part, at this part, spam potions. Thank God this is the last time he does it though, for this guy. His potions are almost out. He could have went for a small charge right there.
Probably would have did a nice little burst. Nice.
Ooh.
My vengeance is complete.
Nice. Like some good loot drops. Early loot drops. Let me know what you guys are thinking about the Sorceress. Looks really strong early game. Really strong. I'm interested to see how it's going to do late game though. But really strong for early game. It'll probably perform even better in end game, honestly. Once you get the right build going or whatever you're building, however you're building it towards, you'll probably end up being even more busted, even though it is kind of scary. It's kind of scary to play as the Sorceress too at the same time, especially when they actually get those hits off on you. You know, she's kind of basically a glass cannon, you know, so I don't know. Let me know what you guys are thinking about. Sorceress, are you going to be playing Sorceress? Let me know what classes you guys are going to be playing. Are you going to be playing hardcore, standard? Let me know all that good stuff, boys. We are getting closer and closer. POE 2. Let's get it. Let's get it, boys.